This is our poppy, man. This is so we're coming up to Remembrance, and you know what? Like the public, you donate a little money, you wear a poppy to say I'm remembering the sacrifice.
Oh, okay.
Me, I remember every day the guys who died, but it's a good time of year to hold that on to hold it close to your heart.
Yeah,
you know?
That's cool.
Yeah, you'll find them anywhere if you want to join in. You just pop it in, pop it on there.
Got it.
Yeah.
I'll look for one.
Cool.
For one.
Yeah. Thanks, man.
Thank you, man.
We will catch these guys in the next 3 or 4 hours. They vanish. How are you going to do this?
There are 21 bridges in and out of the island. Shut them down.
What island?
Manhattan.
Well, tell me a little bit about your movie. I saw it this morning. Tell me what the public can expect when they see your new film.
Well, I guess the conceit of the movie is that, you know, eight cops have been killed, and we need to shut down Manhattan in order to perform this manhunt. For me, it's just a movie that it's a cop thriller. You know, it's the type of movie that where you're on the edge of your seat waiting to see what happens next, and then you have twists and turns, and so you can expect that when you come to see it. So it's a good, it's a good date movie. It's a good, Sunday afternoon movie. It's one of those movies that you just enjoy watching.
So your character is kind of known throughout the force, for lack of a better word, throughout the force, as the guy who hunts cop killers. Mm-hmm. How do you research that? where do you go
you
to
don't,
get that?
You don't research. That's that is hopefully not a real thing. You know what I'm saying? But I think what I tried to do was just sort of get a sense of as far as that's concerned, what is loss like for people that are on the force? Like when you lose somebody that you care about, what does that feel like?
Your father died protecting this city.
Freeze, Jack! Pull!
He taught you to follow your conscience in an often cruel world.
What happened?
Worst day in 18 years.
How many cops?
Case.
Why were they here?
They responded to a robbery.
Shots fired! Down.
Automatic weapons, 2 shooters. They have training.
How old were you when your father's captain came? I asked for you for a reason.
I will find out.
You know, guys on the force will tell you that it's sort of the idea of all hands on deck is a real thing. That, you know, you almost have too much help if a cop is killed or even hurt by someone, that everybody's going to sort of, you know, gather around and try to solve that situation or help that situation. So I just wanted to know what that is. That's the only way you can actually research. And I always try to start from real characters. So I did ride-alongs. I spent a lot of time with detectives and cops in New York and also in LA. Did a lot of firearms training with an officer. And so that's the only way you can, you know, get a sense of what that is.
Do you think it's, I don't know, maybe giving you a new respect for, or a greater respect for the uniformed services, whether they be military, whether it be police, ambulance, all the people who put themselves on the line every day?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. You have a better sense of it because you realize just like, okay, one, they're not just that they're putting themselves in harm's way, but also what does it mean to carry that sort of like stress, you know, like on a day-to-day basis. Like it's not something that you just take off, and then how does that affect your home life? How does it affect, you know, the way you treat your family or the way you the amount of time you get to spend with your family, all of that different stuff. It became blatantly clear, like, oh, this is a lot. And also just holding, you know, a weapon in your hand and how you can make decisions. Like, what do you actually see? Even though I'm not doing it in the real sense, I'm playing it out. I was like, oh, now I understand. He could only see that. You know, he could only fire yeah, at this particular time when he was chasing a person. That's not, you do things in movies that are not real. And so I wanted to make sure I was doing things that felt like they were real, as opposed to like just, you know.
I mean, you don't get any more real than the actual rules of engagement.
Right.
You know, like the time to pull the trigger, time not to pull the trigger.
Right.
It's one of the things, before they throw me out of here, it's one of the things that I really, really liked about the film is the effort you guys put in with your firearms training, with your fire maneuver, with your clearance drills. Like when you guys are clearing down halls and you guys are covering arcs, looking here, looking there, it was really professionally done.
Right.
You guys must have had a really good military advisor.
Yeah. Well, I did SWAT training. We cleared buildings. Like we did all that stuff. So, I was with NYPD, like literally doing it with them. And you know, it felt like at a certain point I was like, well, maybe I could have done this. Maybe this could have been a profession, you know, if I wasn't acting. So I definitely had more respect for it than I did before.
I love it, man. Thank you for taking the time to talk to me.
Thank you, man.
And I'll see you next time.
All right.
And good luck.
Thank you.
They told me you were the guy who kills killers.
Beautiful. What could go wrong? You got a trigger.
You better have perfect diction calling me a trigger.
This was a setup.
Call it what you want.
I just did.
You go down this road, you're looking over your shoulder the rest of your life.
I'd rather look the devil in the eye.